Back with Senator Rand Paul. Senator, is it appropriate for the president-elect to make this charge, a charge that millions of people voted illegally in this most recent presidential election?
I don't quite understand it. I do think that there are two sort of separate issues. Sometimes he says the elections are rigged, and sometimes we're talking about there being bias. And I think there is sometimes bias in the news media. We all say one side or the other, and we think our side's not presented fairly sometimes. But as far as the elections, whether or not they're legitimate, we've had time periods in our history when we've had problems. We've had people go to jail in Kentucky for rigging elections, Texas back in the 50s, 60s, 70s. But I think it's probably better than it used to be. I think people still worry about systemic cheating, like someone hacking into computers because it's become computerized. So I think it's important as we go forward to make sure that there are very visible checks and balances that people can see, because I don't think we want to distrust our system. I largely do trust our electoral
system.
When he
says millions, his words, millions of people who voted illegally. I mean, that there's no evidence that millions of people voted illegally.
Yeah, I don't know anything about that.
But you lose faith in the president-elect when he makes a charge like that?
I just don't understand it.
And then you just want to leave it like that?
Yeah, I mean, I just don't know what to say about something I don't have a lot of information about. And I don't think that there are millions of people that
because
are voting
people,
illegally.
You know, people say it's very hurtful to the U.S. Democracy. People around the world are watching the United States. The president-elect of the United States tweeted, in addition to winning the Electoral College in a landslide, I won the popular vote if you deduct the millions of people who voted illegally. Then he had another tweet. He said, serious voter fraud in Virginia, New Hampshire, and California. So why is the media reporting on this serious bias, big problem? Have you seen evidence of serious voter fraud in those three states?
No, but I think there is concern, and I think what we need to do probably as we move forward, because people are picking up and placing these doubts about our electoral system. There was talk of Russians hacking the system, people hacking into our computers, that I think, and I do meet people who are worried about the integrity of the system, that maybe being more public with the way our checks and balances work. So for example, in my state, it's done by paper. You fill out the paper, it goes in. The judges sitting there will see the tally. So if the tally was 500 to 300 and it got changed by the master computer, they would see that their precinct wasn't reported the same way they do. So we do have checks and balances in every precinct. But I can tell you, when I was a kid, I remember one of my dad's elections, there were 3,000 people that voted in the same handwriting, and we thought there was fraud. So there is fraud sometimes, but typically it's not illegal people voting. It's a bad judge. It's a judge who decides to vote for people who never showed up.
Let's talk about Mitt Romney.